Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I guess I am doing a 2019 Best of Beauty lifestyle video. Well, it's not really best of beauty if it's lifestyle, but I do have a few beauty things in this video. I'm talking about some brushes and a little bit about some fragrance. And as for lifestyle, I have things that just really made an impact on me in 2019 in regards to jewelry, fashion, and just general things that help my life be a little bit better, a little bit easier. Now I know when you follow a beauty channel, lifestyle might not be your cup of tea. And I completely get that. I mostly do beauty content here. I got a lovely comment from a viewer in my last video. Could care less about inane TV shows and her travel. Tune in for beauty products and tutorials. Isn't that lovely? So this video is going to be for those of you who are like me and like to hear a little bit about just random things that people love. And I like that. And I know a lot of you like that too. So I wanted to do this video for you guys. So if you are not subscribed to my channel yet and you enjoy everyday beauty made easy, beauty and tips that you can take and apply to your everyday life that are doable and achievable, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and become part of the family. And let's get into what I loved as far as lifestyle products with a little bit of beauty thrown in 2019. I'm going to start with the first beauty segment and get it out of the way. That is brushes. I am going to be doing a brushes video here shortly, probably if not this month, next month, covering all of my favorite most used brushes of all time. It's a video you guys have been asking me about a ton and I really want to do it for you. So I'm just covering the ones that I feel like I've used the most in 2019 and I'm just going to do that very quickly for you. I hope it's very quickly. So the first one is kind of a surprise for me and probably will be for you too if you follow my channel. This is the Huda Beauty Tantour Face Sculpt and Shade Brush. It's a dual-ended brush. Since I've delved more into cream products this year and liquid products, this has entered my life. Now, I don't really use the Tantour product. I need to update you all on that as well because I don't think I followed up with you on that. This just applies contour and bronzer perfectly and seamlessly. It just is so quick. I love that both sides have a bit of a slant to them. So no matter if you are contouring or going along the hairline or full out bronzing, dabbing or swirling, it just performs beautifully and very smoothly. I've been loving this brush. And now I'm going to talk about a brush set that is just forever out of stock. And so that I'm going to fly through it, but I love it. I love every brush in this set. And I really do hope that they restock this soon. I use these every day. This is the Sonia G Sky Face Set. It is available on Beautylish. I use this for highlighter pretty much every day. This is the soft cheek and this is the classic cheek. And at first I was wondering why on earth is she putting two blush brushes in one face set. Because all blushes are created differently, you really do need to have a couple of different types of blush brushes in your arsenal. You need a denser one that's still soft and doesn't feel scratchy, but picks up a lot of pigment when you have those ones that are a little bit harder and don't lay down as much product, the ones that you really need to build up. That's where the classic cheek brush comes in. The soft cheek brush is the one that I use more often just because a lot of the blushes that I use have just regular pigment or are pretty pigmented. And this one just applies them beautifully and diffuses everything so nicely. It's so soft. They are shaped a little bit differently, but that is how I use these brushes and it's worked for me very, very well. Now, I have not been a fan of fan brushes. I said that I think in a video recently too, when I was talking about the Wayne Goss Holiday Brush, which is much bigger than this brush. I actually compare the two in my December favorites. This is the Worker fan brush. And I think that she has a similar fan brush on the site that's available separately. If she does, I'll link it. I'll have all these products linked down below. This really converted me over to certain types of fan brushes because there is some density here. It's not totally flat. It's very, very soft. So I have been using this to contour a lot. I don't so much use it to highlight. This is really a great contour brush. It gets along the hairline really nicely. It's just beautiful and I do use it for powders. And this face brush, I love it so much. This is what I apply my finishing powder with after I've finished my makeup and I throw on my diffusing finishing powder. It is dense yet soft and domed and it just Applies the powder so beautifully and perfectly, and it doesn't pick up too much product either, so there's not a lot of powder kick up. And finally, BK Beauty. I know a lot of you have bought Lisa J's brushes or her sets, however you have bought them. I do have a link with a 10% off code down below. These are the ones that I use the most out of any, and I'll just go through them very, very quickly because I feel like I'm going to talk about brushes for too long. I use the 203 to blend out my cream shadows at the crease. I use the 201 as my transition brush. You may have seen me use this 106 brush recently to apply my liquid blushes. It is a foundation brush, but I find that it just blends out and applies liquid and cream blushes beautifully, and it's just the perfect size. The 103 bronzer brush has been used a ton by me this year. The 102 powder brush has also been used a ton to dust off any excess powder or apply powder. Both of those are very dense and soft. All of her brushes are super soft. Okay, so 2019 is when I got my Loopy case, which I've talked about in a favorites video. I mean, a lot of these I have talked about in favorites videos because they're favorites of mine. I got this after my phone fell off my pop socket, and I have not looked back since. I actually want to get just another pattern. So the case is made to where the loop is just completely through there, so you don't have a chance of your phone falling out of the case. The one drawback is that you can't charge it if you use the charging disc. You do have to pop it off to charge it, but it's very easy to pop on and off. I don't have any issues at all. It just makes it so easy to carry the phone. I'm not nervous about having it hanging off my finger or fingers, however I'm carrying it. And there's also a nice bumper to it. It's very protected, which, you know, I feel like I need. So I am so glad that I discovered this year. I discovered Bai in 2019, the drink. I don't have one here with me because I'm out and I need to get some more. But they're basically flavored waters, and I've had their superfruit teas, and they're delicious also. I described it in my favorites video as Kool-Aid for adults because they're not so sugary sweet that you just get too much of it. They're just the right amount. And oddly enough, I feel like their teas are a little bit sweeter than the waters. They're called antioxidant infusions. It says each serving of Bai offers fresh fruit flavor infused with coffee fruit, which is a super fruit and has antioxidants, and they are sweetened with stevia leaf extract. So they're not sweetened with the chemical artificial sweeteners. It's a 5-calorie drink, which I think is amazing because it really does taste refreshing. Now, I had one viewer in my favorites video where I talked about these tell me that these were horribly bad for you and I should look it up. Can I tell you how long I researched that and looked up different phrases, different ways to find out if these were somehow bad for us? Every single article, every single thing I found said that they were actually good for you. So I have to think that she was mixing them up with something else. If anybody knows anything, let me know. But as of now, I love that I discovered these in 2019. I feel like 2019 was the year of jewelry for me. I finally broke down and got some rings that were not my wedding ring set and that I enjoy wearing every day. Now, I do alternate some of these. I just threw them all on for this video. I don't always wear all of them, but I've just been wanting some different rings to wear, and I finally found some that I really like. The two right here in the center are from Monica Vinader, and I just love them so much. I wear those probably more than any of the others. Now, I'll have the links to all of these down below because these are from different retailers, but I just love stacking these. Now, the middle silver one was my grandmother's wedding band, but the rest I've all purchased from different places and I've been enjoying wearing them. I just feel a little bit more accessorized, you know? And I do have to give a shout out to Gorjana because this is the year that they asked me to be an ambassador, which basically means that I get pieces sent to me ahead of time and I can pick out certain pieces to focus on, which I love because I've been purchasing from Gorjana for a couple of years now, and it was just really nice to be recognized by them. And so I am wearing some of their pieces now. This has been a signature piece for me, this necklace, for probably 2 years now. And I would say in 2019, this became quite a signature piece for me, this little necklace right here that hangs pretty much the same way. It's just got the chain links on it. And then these might be my favorite earrings of 2019. I've just been really loving these. Gorjana's style, it's just very simplistic and it just resonates with me. And so I really enjoy being able to share those pieces with you guys more regularly now that I'm an ambassador for them. So that's pretty exciting. I know I've talked about Barefoot Dreams before, but in 2019, I did get the Barefoot Dreams Circle cardigan. I've had other Barefoot Dreams cardigans that I have loved, but I feel like this one is it. This is the one that I feel like I can throw on with kind of anything, or I can wear it at home. And not only is it super soft, some of them have a little bit of a different type of a knit to them. I love the way this one feels, and I just love the way it looks. Like, I can throw this on with leggings and a t-shirt and boots, and it looks like a really cute outfit, or I can throw it on at home if I'm cold, and it also works really great for that too. So I just really love the cut of this a little bit more than some of the other Barefoot Dreams cardigans that I have. Okay, I have one more Barefoot Dreams thing, small thing, and then I'm gonna move on to fragrance. In 2019, I somehow acquired 3 pairs of Barefoot Dreams socks. Now I have this shade and I have 2 kind of pinky blush shades, and I'm not sorry. These are the softest fuzzy socks ever, and they're just the right amount of thickness. I actually bought 2 of them and I was gifted 1 of them. They're a great gift item. They're the perfect treat yourself fuzzy sock, and I'm so glad that I have them, and I have worn these so much throughout the year. I'm a little scared I'm gonna wear them out, but they just keep lasting. You know, when you get yourself, or if someone gets you, a fragrance set, you really don't think it's gonna make a big impact on you, or it's gonna make that much of a difference. You just kind of think, okay, great, it's a fragrance set and I'll move on with my life. Well, I got this Jo Malone fragrance set that we all saw everywhere around, what, November or something like that. I have owned Peony and Blush Suede fragrance from Jo Malone for, I feel like, well over a year. It's one of my all-time favorite perfumes, and it's in this set, but I've actually discovered 3 other fragrances that I really, really love that I never would have known about. Wood Sage and Sea Salt. Yes, I know, it's a cult favorite. And the Honeysuckle and Devona. Wow, I'm not even a honeysuckle fan, but it just smells so nice on me. I get compliments on both it and the Wood Sage and Sea Salt every time I wear them. Every single time. And the English Pear and Freesia as well. It's just so fresh. I just am so glad that I picked this set up, and I love having these in the smaller size too, but it's not too small of a size. So I had no idea when I got this. I hope this is still available, because if you haven't gotten this and you've been wanting to delve into the world of Jo Malone, this would be a really great way to do that. I'm gonna keep these next few items kind of short and sweet because I just talked about them in my recent must-have Amazon items, but they are must-have items and they are from Amazon, and they did make a huge difference in my life in 2019. So I've had this steamer since before 2019, but I didn't really start using it until 2019, and it has made a huge difference in my laundry life. I just feel like I hardly ever have to iron anymore, truly. Anytime I need to iron something, I just pull out my steamer and it takes care of it, and it's so much faster. I don't have to deal with the ironing board or the iron. I hate ironing, and this is just amazing. I have to link some that are similar because I don't think they have this particular one on Amazon. If I can find this one somewhere else, I'll link it. It is small, it's light, it heats up within 60 seconds, and it does the job, and it doesn't spit water everywhere like my last steamer did. And that's probably why I was so turned off from steamers for so long. I'm just so glad and thankful that I started actually using this regularly in 2019, because it has made my life so much easier. I also spoke about my laptop setup in that video because I started having some neck issues, a pinched nerve thing going on. I ended up in physical therapy because I just was looking down too much while I was typing on my laptop, having it at my desk or at a table. So I ended up getting this laptop stand. It just helps elevate my laptop to more of a desktop level, to where I'm looking straight forward, so I don't have that ache and pain anymore. Now, because the laptop is elevated, that means the keyboard is elevated. So I did get an external keyboard as well as an external trackpad. You can get a mouse, but because I'm just so used to working off of a trackpad on my laptop, I got an external trackpad. If these are charged, you do not need a cord to connect them. They just sync right up with your computer. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. It's very easy and very portable to just move this from table to desk or wherever. I had a bad thing happen, but I had something good come of it, because I really, really did need to make my setup more ergonomic, because I am at my laptop so many hours a day. It's ridiculous, and I just needed to be healthy about it. I do realize how much I have spoken about Athleta in 2019 and how I truly probably sound like a broken record, but I've truly always loved their clothing. I feel like it has always lasted me years and years and years, way longer than some other premium athletic wear has lasted me. And I discovered three pieces in particular this year that I now have multiples of because I loved them that much. The first is this hoodie that I have on. I've talked about it before. It's not thick. It's more of a very, very soft, regular shirt material. It's got thumb holes. It's got a hoodie. It's got a curved hem, and it comes in many different colors. I adore it. And those of you who have this, love it as much as I do. And guess what? It comes with a regular neck as well, not just a hoodie. And I have that in multiple colors too. The next item is the Elation Tight in the Power Vita fabric. And now it's the Power Vita fabric that is what feels like nothing. And I do have something else in that fabric that I love too. It's not thick, it's not confining, it does wick away sweat. It has compression, but it feels like you are wearing nothing. You can sleep in them, you can lounge in them, you can work out in them. They wash well, they wear well. I just love everything about these leggings. I have two pairs in black and I have a couple other colors too, and I'm not sure if I'll ever buy anything that's not in this Power Vita fabric. I would wear them all day long, all night long, if it was socially acceptable. And the last is this sports bra that both me and my 14-year-old love. And there are two different size groupings for it. It comes in A to C cup, or I think D to double D cup. This is just such a great sports bra if you want something that is stylish, but that offers support as well, and it's not too hot or stifling. It's also super soft. So this is another item that you can work out in or you can lounge in it. It's just perfect. I also have this in multiple colors as well. A huge thank you to you guys for making my 2019 such a great year. I hit 100,000 subscribers this year, and I could not be happier with just how my channel is going. And I also launched my social media consulting business and completely revamped my website and have a new website up. I feel like I did a lot in 2019. So I'm going to include that in this video because those are accomplishments that I'm proud of and that you have all had a part in. And I'm just excited. I'm excited at what 2020 might bring all of us. So thank you so much for watching. If you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. I would love to have you here with me in 2020 and from here forward. Let me know what's worked for you in 2019 and what you're looking forward to in 2020 in the comments below. I love hearing from you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video, for being here with me. I'm so thankful for you, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.